Bienvenue.
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 Sorry. Bienvenue. Bienvenue.
Buenos dias.
Pour le fancasting. Ton parle pas Game of Thrones, yes?
Yes.
Oui? Oui. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Ah, yes. 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 Je suis.
I am.
All right, what's going on, guys? Mark here from Fancasted.
Sean here from Fancasted.
And we are breaking down Season 8, Episode 4 of Game of Thrones, and I am quite drunk.
We only have two goddamn episodes left!
We have two more episodes left, and I am stressed out!
I'm struggling. Okay. I'm struggling hard.
All right, let's try to break this episode down as best as we can, as fast as we can, because these women are waiting for us to be done. Okay.
the women
have names. No, they don't. All right, so.
Listen, unless you're in the video, you got credits to a name. Continue. We'll put Courtney in the credits. Anybody else not.
Technical producer there. All right. Okay. So wow, a lot has happened. This picks up exactly right where we left off in episode 3. We are literally right at the beginning of the episode where we are burning the bodies of Jorah Mormont and Theon Greyjoy. And it is very sad.
What about Lyanna?
And Lyanna Mormont of Bear Island. Oh my god.
You mentioned Theon, but not Lyanna.
I know. Right. Well, you know
that
right.
That was
disrespect.
Theon got more screen time. What do you want me to do?
Look, Theon got more kills.
He did get more kills.
Precedence.
You want to be in the video?
I feel like if Sam was picked by the giant, he would have done the same thing.
So. He would have done the same. No, he would have done the
same. Yeah, but right. Gimli is also a bitter person towards elves. So
we're not talking about Gimli. He's a racist.
We're talking about Game of Thrones. Right.
Gimli's a racist. We know this. Okay, yeah. So. So it is a pretty. Sad and I can't think of the word for sad.
Stupid.
Somber. It is an incredibly somber event. And
we knew what was coming after the war.
We
did. There was going to be a whole bunch of discussion about what to do with Cersei, how to deal with Cersei, and who was doing the fight.
Which, to their credit, I thought they were going to go right into, but they at least allowed a bit of a period for them to rest and celebrate the fact that they just won a zombie apocalypse.
Medieval times version of a zombie apocalypse.
Yeah, exactly. It was nice.
This episode was not very, very.
No,
very
it wasn't incredibly uplifting.
It was sad. Most Game of Thrones episodes
are. We're trying to keep the happy parts rolling right now, but it goes straight in. I mean, right from the dinner celebration of life. We get scenes where Daenerys is clearly uncomfortable with the idea that everybody is rallying behind Jon Snow.
Aegon Targaryen.
Aegon
Targaryen.
But all of that is sidelined because Brienne of Tarth lost her virginity
to Jaime Lannister.
So
I didn't find that appealing at all.
No, not even a little bit. There's a lot of virginities being lost that I did not need in this episode. I did not need that. I kind of was. There's pork being cooked. I was really hoping. I was really hoping that this would be a relationship that was left platonic. And of course not, because it's Game of Thrones.
I was going to say, we knew what was going to happen when Jaime sacrificed his right hand.
I know, but.
For granted, but.
Why can't there be just some female and male relationships that are just not. You know, like, I don't know. Anyway, the point is.
I was going to say, technically, Grey Worm.
you're an asshole.
Technically, it's on technicality. You can't do this, so you got one counterpart to it.
Anyway, the point is.
do the thing that they, but
they really leaned in into the episode with having each person bear a torch for each person that was lost, that was significant to them.
Yeah.
Sansa burning Theon, Jon Snow burning Lyanna of Bear Island.
And Daenerys burning Jorah.
Yeah, and after that, the celebrations are held. Everybody has a little bit of a personal moment. We see Tyrion Lannister playing one hell of a wingman for Jaime Lannister. Good stuff all around. And then we get into the meat.
And then we get into the bad stuff.
Yeah.
Varys talking about essentially dethroning Daenerys because she doesn't have some crazy plans.
All right, we all gotta have different opinions on this. I know the party that we had watching with us had varied opinions on this.
We had the same opinion.
We did. It's weird. I know.
That's the first really time. That's the first time.
Thing. I know.
Daenerys can't
be queen.
We both thought Daenerys can't
be.
She
oh my
borderline
God.
On mad.
She's on some crazy shit right
she
now.
She about to turn into her dad.
Oh my God.
And that's not
she's
cool.
Crazy.
That's not good.
I mean, it doesn't help what Cersei did, but we'll get to that.
I'm thinking about this logically now. If Daenerys takes over King's Landing and Arya kills her like Jaime does, and then Jon snoops in for the win.
I know.
I hope you know that's coming.
I know.
Alright then.
I don't think they're gonna do it though.
I don't know.
We got two more episodes.
If we got two more episodes, then there's a lot that went on in this episode.
There was. Okay, so let's get right into it. So, pretty much immediately, there is a meeting of the Starks between Arya, Sansa, Bran, and Jon. And essentially, everybody except for Bran, who continues to do nothing.
He's a terrible baby.
He's useless. He tells Jon, they all tell Jon, like, yo, bro, your queen is, like, cray-cray, and you need to, like, not listen to her, because she's a crazy person.
You need to deal with that. And then Jon proceeds to tell them that he's not a Stark.
Yeah.
And then Bran spills the beans that he, in fact, is only a half-Stark.
But before that, Jon and Daenerys have a conversation in which she literally begs him
not to reveal to his family that he's a Stark.
Yeah.
Or, sorry, a Targaryen.
A Targaryen.
Sorry,
yeah.
My bad.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, I don't think that's going to go over well with anybody.
It's not. He already told his family that he's a Targaryen.
He 100. Immediately. He didn't even wait. So, Jon, you fucked up for that. But the point is that immediately after that, we get some good farewells. Sam Tarly. And his now wife, pregnant wife, Gilly, have decided to take off and go onto their own adventures. Wolfsbane has decided to go off onto his own adventures, and they do a farewell.
The Hound is going on to his own ship.
And nobody knows where Arya is.
Arya's
Arya
gets proposed.
Proposed to.
Gendry comes out and he's like, So Daenerys promoted me to Lord at the beginning of the episode, and I'm finna make you Lady. And Arya's like, nah, I ain't finna be Lady, I'm finna be Arya Stark.
She hit him with the slick, and she's like, yo, man, we had some fun. She said that,
She essentially be like, listen, back then when we were kids, I was looking for an itch to scratch, and it's been a while, and you itched my scratch, and it wasn't that good, so.
Ah, damn. I guess his stroke game wasn't that good. But the point is,
he's a Baratheon. None of the stroke game was good.
That's also fair. But the point, look, he got rejected. Mm-hmm. But he didn't take it too hard. To his credit, he really didn't take it to heart as of yet. Mm. He looks like he took it pretty respectfully. But anyways,
he looked like he took it
pretty. No, he was heartbroken. He loves her. But like, you know, he didn't do the thing where he like punched drywall, you know? Yeah. He was alright.
The white guy thing.
I was trying to say it, but
all right. White guys punch drywall. I don't know what to deal with.
I don't know what that is.
I've never seen a black guy go like, you know what, and throw hands at drywall.
We won't talk about that. Mm. Alright, so anyways. Sansa talks to Daenerys, and essentially during the War Council meeting, establishes the fact, and this is a fact, that their soldiers are tired. They're war tired, you know what I mean? And they can't jump from this war straight into fighting
Cersei. They fought the Army of the Undead and the Night King for a good while.
It was a good, long fight.
And half of them were drunk because they knew going into the fight that half of them wouldn't survive.
And they didn't.
And they didn't.
No, they didn't.
So, essentially what had happened is Daenerys was like, you know what? I'm finna take my crown now because if I give them more time to prep, yeah, they're going to come back with some fire, which they actually did.
They
killed a dragon.
Straight up. As soon as they set sail, the dragons are flying out ahead as like a garrison. And as soon as they fly out, one of the dragons, gone. One arrow to the wing, one arrow to the neck, gone.
All right. One arrow to the chest, one arrow to the wing, one arrow to the neck.
Oh, sorry, I missed the first one.
Yeah, it's all good.
All right, and yeah, so now we're at one dragon because of one person's arrogance. They get stranded onto the beach, and that is where we realize that Missandei is gone. Missandei has been captured by the Lannisters, and by the Lannisters, I just mean Cersei. And boom, like they waste no time. In the next scene, we see her. She's strung up. She's right by the front of the gates of the city. And everybody's there waiting. They're waiting to see. Now, Daenerys goes in and they're like, yo, bro, you have to give Cersei an opportunity to surrender. And Daenerys is like, fire and blood, fire and blood, fire
whoa,
and
blood. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Before we go into that,
hit it.
We're thinking now where Varys is coming in is like, okay, they establishedly brought all the people, all the poor people from King's Landing into the castle stronghold.
Which is pretty cool because historically that happened.
Which is Cersei's plan because she doesn't want the people to turn on her,
yeah,
even though she hates the hell out of them.
And she's using them as a human shield.
She essentially is. Yeah. Even though it's not going to work, because we know Drogon will fly straight to the capital and burn.
I mean, we'll see.
But, moving on from that, that's her whole plan. She's using them as a meat shield,
yeah,
and Daenerys is like, listen, if we got to go through people, we got to go through people. I don't care at this point. She done messed up and killed one of my babies. I'm finna take King's Landing and burn everybody that I see if they're siding with the queen.
Yeah. And that's what it is. Now, we should have known that something was up as soon as Missandei started talking with Grey Worm about their future plans.
Yeah,
we know
I knew that
Game
was
of Thrones, that is like...
I knew one of them two was dying for 100%.
Oh my god.
Can we speak on the dark horse in this episode?
Let's talk about it.
Bronn came in like a... like a true man. He came into Winterfell undetected. He came in and talked to both Lannister brothers, shot an arrow at one of them,
broke
and
the
is like, I'm
goes.
Not playing. I want my money today.
I think that, I gotta be real, man. What was his name? Jeremy Flynn, I think his name is, the actor that plays Bronn. He came in like he was in a different movie. Like, everybody else was doing Game of Thrones, and this guy came in and said, no, this is Pulp Fiction. Like, he was just like, look,
I want my money.
Like, he was like, bitch slapping people.
He's like, listen, great. I've been promised a lot of things, and a lot of things ain't been due. You promised me, your sister promised me, nobody ain't giving me no dues. I want my money.
It's crazy because I thought that he would actually do, like, he would back down based on the sentiment that him and Tyrion had and him and Jaime had. They had a long line of adventures together, like 3 seasons straight of adventures.
Doesn't
and he's like,
Bronn
I don't
liked
care.
Any of that.
I don't care.
He's like, I'm betting on the Dragon Queen to beat Cersei,
yeah.
So
and he's like,
I'm not killing y'all today,
yeah.
But if anything happens to jeopardize that future, I'm coming for your neck.
He's like, look, man.
Period.
Y'all better hope that Cersei kills y'all in the war. Because he's like, the way I'm about to kill y'all, look. Oh my god, Bronn was definitely MVP of the episode.
Yep.
There was a little scene in there, but I loved every second of it. It was great. Yeah, But we gotta talk about the real, real dark of the episode, the cliffhanger. I can't even go on about this. You go right ahead.
Mm-mm.
All right, go ahead.
I think you should take over.
Okay, go well, forward. Here we go. Essentially, Tyrion Lannister goes in and he goes to talk to his sister, Cersei.
There's a meeting of minds.
There's a meeting of minds.
Small little army, and then there's Cersei's long ass army. Along
right
the wall.
At the gate of the city,
with all the arrow cannons.
And if I can quote Obi-Wan Kenobi, they got the high ground.
Yeah.
All right. And, you know, Tyrion goes into talk. He's like, look, man, I know you love your children. I know there's some good in you.
Whoa, hold up. You're going too fast. He goes to talk to the Grand Maester first.
Oh, yeah.
Grand Maester's like, listen, to be honest, we come in at a mutual agreement where both our queens are asking for surrender. We ain't going to talk much about it. My queen's got the higher ground.
Yep.
That's what the Grand Maester says.
Yeah.
On knowing that Drogon's still going to wreck all of them.
I mean, but he did say that their dragon is vulnerable, which is true.
I mean, it's still in the sense, as vulnerable as Drogon is, Drogon's still a boss. He'll take out half their kingdom. But moving on from that.
He essentially
just casts out the Grand Maester. He's like, you ain't none. I'm going to talk to my sister. So he goes to his sister. He's like, yo, in facts, I don't want to kill my nephew. I don't want to kill you. I don't want to see this kingdom burn down. I don't want to see innocent people die.
And
essentially.
Now, if I can quote Stokely Carmichael, when he said that the problem with appealing to the higher power in this situation and their morality is the fact that the higher power doesn't have morality. All right? He tried to talk to his sister on like a level. Like, we grew up together.
On a level of morality.
I know your children. I know what happened. I love you. I don't want to see you suffer. And she was like, this is Sparta! Like, she just straight up. Oh.
Okay, so essentially what had happened was if they didn't surrender, someone was going to die.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Grey Worm's chick was going to die.
Yeah. I don't know if I'm calling her that because she's so much more than that.
Much more than that, but I don't remember her name.
Masande.
Okay, so Masande stares standing at the edge of the cliff.
Yeah.
Cersei asks her basically any last words. Masande says the one command that
should have saved
everybody ablaze, Dracarys. What do you think of that?
I mean, I was waiting for Drogon to come up right behind them and just fry everybody. But of course not, because there's two more episodes, so obviously there has to be conflict.
There's going to be a war.
And
there's going to be another war. 100%.
I mean, she really, that was her last dying breath. Her last dying breath was her undying adoration and belief in her queen.
What we're basically saying is the Mountain came out and pulled out his sword and beheaded Masande right in front of everybody.
Grey Worm couldn't even look.
Grey Worm couldn't look. Daenerys, unfortunately, was at scene to that. She turned around immediately.
Oh, and you can
and
just
was
see,
like, you
can
see
her
seething.
I mean, Courtney from Fancast, and she was watching, and she literally quoted. She was like, you can literally just see the moment that she snapped. That was it. She's done. She's not a human anymore.
The moment,
that's it.
The moment people snap their fingers with the Infinity. That's what you saw in that phase.
Oh my god.
I gotta give props in this episode to Emilia Clarke for pulling out that emotion that she needed to.
She was great,
bro.
And Cersei, I mean, y'all already know Lena Headey continues to be the women we love to hate. Like, she's acting the hell out of this scene. Oh, by the way,
besides
can we just
that
get
emotional level.
Yeah.
Jaime
and Brienne of Tarth. Jaime and Brienne of Tarth have a conversation where he's like, yo, bro, I gotta leave.
No, we gotta rewind.
Oh, hit it, go.
So they're playing Tyrion's favorite drinking game, which is basically truth or dare.
Yeah.
And
it feels like more like never.
The man exposed her. He's like, you're a virgin. You never had sex with a man or a woman ever in your life.
Don't ask nobody.
So basically, Brienne leaves the table, and Jaime's like, "Okay, you fucked up. I'm gonna go fix this." Jaime goes to the room to go fix it, and he actually fixes.
Oh no! He actually fixes it.
So basically, Jaime and Brienne end up sleeping together.
Yes, they do.
So she loses her virginity, and she really loves Jaime, like really to a do. Fault.
They both.
So
love each
she
other.
Pretty much does what Daenerys says she never ever does, is beg, and she begs Jaime to stay and not go to King's Landing and not deal with his sister, and he still does it anyway.
But he does it with redemption in mind. I mean, the way he breaks it down is that he essentially says, look, I crippled a boy, I've slaughtered people, and I would slaughter more people just for the whim of my sister, who I loved at the time. I need to make this right. Like, what kind of person would I be if I didn't make this right? And you know what? It just goes to show what a journey we've come through with Jaime Lannister, who had this kind of idea of like this knight, this tarnished knight, who really wasn't caring about anything that he did, you know? And has just come to a point now where he's like, look, I literally can't live with myself as I am until I really make this wrong right. Which I've said three times. Again, I've been drinking. The point is,
you're not the only one.
Look, it's crazy. I can't wait to see exactly what he does to play out in this war. I strongly believe that it's either going to be him or Arya Stark who takes out Cersei. But, I mean, Arya Stark already took out the Night King.
Yeah, that's maybe exactly why Jaime's going to get this kill.
I
think Jaime's going to get this kill. He deserves it. She done killed his youngest son. Okay. And there was no repercussions for that.
There were none. Exactly. There really were none. All right, anyways, this video has gone on long enough. We really got to wrap this down. But, guys, what did you think of season 8, episode 4?
We have two more episodes.
We got two more episodes to go, man.
Oh, God. And they're much longer than the episodes that have come out.
Jesus.
So, if you like what you saw, don't forget to like, share, subscribe.
Hey,
follow us on YouTube at Keely Noir Pictures. Yeah. Hit the notification bell to find out when we drop videos.
Because we
continuously drop. If you haven't seen what we dropped recently, we dropped a Batman video recently.
We did.
We dropped a Mortal Kombat video recently.
We did.
This man done talked about Black Panther for a good minute marvelous scene.
Yeah.
And that's taking a hit. Like, he's gone. Over.
We also talked about the MCU, and we got brand new videos dropping about that as well.
Exactly. We got Star Wars, we got My Moon, we got Unknown Arts, we got Wise Up. Everything is on the channel. If you haven't peeked at it, please, the link is in the description. Just go follow us. We're also Fancast Prime on Twitter.
Yeah.
Tweet us. We will actually respond to you.
We will.
And we will
it's crazy.
Consider videos for your entertainment. We got Fancast on Instagram, where he constantly posts stuff and I constantly review, as well as everybody else. And then we also have our Facebook channel, which is for old people.
It's
true. Nobody uses Facebook
30,
anymore.
Check it out. All right, it's so cool.
Well, between 25 and 30, between 25 and 30, and you're still on Facebook. Follow us on Facebook.
And of course, if you are keeping up with Game of Thrones, and we drop new episodes each week, recovering and reviewing each episode and talking about what we thought about it. If you have any comments about what this episode brought to the table, your favorite moment, if you have any theories about what's going to go down for next week, let us know in the comments section and I will argue with you. Trust me, it's going to happen. All right. Anyways, I've been Mark.
I've been Sean, and these have been Jazz Hands. We will see you next time.
Bye.